Are you all ready for class?
Apparently Dr. Batts is bringing Steelio back.
Oh yeah! I remember Dr. Batts introducing him to us in Mechanics and Materials. If class today goes anything like the rap videos he made us make on the first day of class, I feel like it's going to be quite interesting.
Welcome to Skill Class, where we'll be designing some. I hope you're ready for some analysis fun. We got load combinations and factors of reduction. Don't forget to check all the limit states, son. Yielding, fracture, block shear, bolted and welded connection, flexural, torsional, local buckling, and compression, beams and BMP, and lateral buckling with torsion. Don't forget to check it against the ISC manual. Then you're done.
Yeah, that was sick.
My precious Steelio. Oh, welcome class. Today we're going to be learning more in depth about our friend Steelio. I'm sure you've all heard of Steelio by now. He's going to teach us more about our favorite material, steel, and its stress strain properties. Let me pass Steelio around so that you have a chance to get to meet him and talk to him.
Could you go over the stress strain curve again?
Sure, TK. Let me show you.
Okay, so first we start by drawing a simple stress strain graph for a ductile metal like steel. On the x-axis, we will draw strain, or epsilon. And on the y-axis, we will plot stress, or sigma. At the very beginning, we have what we call the linear elastic range, which has a slope of E, or the modulus of elasticity. You remember what that is?
Is that your ability to stretch and recover? When I hear elastic, I think of a rubber band returning to its original length after the load is moved.
Exactly. In steel design, we will take my modulus of elasticity to be 29,000 KSI. And that slope works up to my yield stress, Fy. After yielding, things change dramatically.
Wait, what value do you use for Fy?
Oh yeah, to calculate the yield stress using test data, we use the 0.2% offset method. Where it intersects the curve, that's the value of Fy. In steel design, however, the yield stress is based on the material grade specified by the engineer. Me, I'm a high-strength, low-alloy man, or ASTM A572 grade 50. But structural steel can come in a variety of grades. For a full listing for structural shapes, check out AISE Table 2-4. And for plates and bars, check out AISE Table 2-5. After yielding, things change dramatically. Once steel yields, it begins to stretch without any increase in force. We call this the yield plateau, and the length varies depending on the grade. Some steels, especially the high-strength varieties, will have little to no yield plateau, whereas others, like a mild carbon ASTM A36 steel, will have a longer yield plateau.
Why is the data all jagged, though?
Well, when steel yields, at the material level, we are forcing dislocations through the steel grains, causing the material to slip or slide apart. At some point in the linear elastic range, we begin to develop permanent strain. This is the proportional limit. Then, at first yield, we get an upper yield point because of friction. Think of this like static friction versus kinetic friction. Once we overcome the static friction by breaking that first bond, it is easier to push the dislocations through the material. As we keep breaking bonds, the force rises and falls a little bit, giving the curve some variation, or what we call Luders bands.
Oh, I see. Then what happens?
Well, then I tap into my superpowers and become even stronger. That's right. All these dislocations that have been shifted get tangled at my grain boundaries, so it requires an even higher force to cause further deformation. Hence the term strain hardening.
I've always wondered why they called it that. Now I'll be able to sleep at night.
I think I remember the rest. The steel continues to get stronger, but at a slower rate. initially 1 to 3% of the original modulus of elasticity. Then we hit the ultimate tensile strength, necking, and fracture.
You got it. In steel, we call this the ultimate stress, F sub U. And again, you can check out AISC tables 2-4 and 2-5 for a quick reference of the values for each material. Steel typically fractures at a strain of 20 to 40%. But again, you can get full details for each grade by looking up the appropriate ASTM spec, keeping in mind that you usually lose ductility as you increase strength. Keep this up, and you will be steel superheroes too. Now that we have a good reminder of the mechanical properties of steels, let's focus on how we're going to use these for steel design.
Wait just a second. I've locked all the doors, and your only hope to escape is for one of you to climb inside and be pulled apart.
Wait a second. Who are you?
It's not just you, but UTM. My full name is Universal Testing Machine, and I will be obeyed. You, in the front, I choose you to be my victim.
Not me! You don't want me. I'm 18% carbon and only 0.06% iron, according to Wikipedia. What hope do I have to survive?
Take me instead. Of course, although I will miss my beloved steel design students, I am willing to take on this stress to better your knowledge and save you from the evil UTM.
Dr. Betts, you can't just let this happen.
This is a sacrifice he's willing to make for your knowledge purpose.
He's necking! Make it stop!
Fear not, class. I'm only getting stronger.
No! No!
No, please don't! Man, I'm gonna miss Steelio!
What an atrocity!
This is unbelievable.
No, poor Steelio!